Hi and hola para amigos. In this video, we're gonna talk about the most important concept of medical education emerged in the last 30 years, competency-based medical education. It will be explained in a short time and in a way that anyone can understand why it is so important. These pretty flamingos are getting ready to explain, but first, the intro. At the end of 19th century, medical education was carried on mostly by using books. One man, William Osler, appeared and said, "Medical students, if you want to learn medicine, you must go to hospital wards. You should spend time with patients. Books are not enough to learn medicine." It was a good step forward for those days. Since those days, however, the traditional medical education was teacher-centered. The only source of information was teacher. Education mostly based on information gathering, not improving higher level skills such as clinical reasoning and learning to learn. It was discipline-based and hospital-based. It had a standard program. There was apprenticeship model that students solely copy what a professor do. It was an opportunistic education that provides some random and irregular opportunities to learn. Assessment was only at the end of the education. It was norm-referenced. What is that? The pass and fail decisions are up to the other students' levels. If you are in a group that consists of students who have high levels, you fail. If you are in a low level students group, you pass even if you have the same level as you failed before. The prominent requirement of graduation was the time. For instance, let's say you are a resident in internal medicine. If you make rotations between departments for 4 years, congrats, you deserve being graduated. It's not important how you spent your time within that period or no matter the quality of learning. The traditional medical education had such a shape. Complete your years, be doctor. What a dark time. In 1990s, something has changed. It was a gradual change that started before 90s, but there was a rapid transform in 90s. The name of the change was outcome-based and competency-based medical education, CBME. In CBME, the pass-fail decisions are not given according to the required amount of time. The only important thing is outcome, and this outcome should be competence at least. You cannot deserve graduation certificate since you just spent your years inside the borders of the medical environment. You have to show that you are competent. The competency areas and levels are certain before you enter. You know what the target is before starting your education journey. Until the graduation time, any method can be used to reach competency level that you need. What are the levels? For instance, Dreyfus and Dreyfus defined them in their framework: novice, advanced beginner, competent, proficient, expert. If you want to get MD degree, you have to reach the competent level minimum and prove that you reached. In CBME, assessment is not norm referenced, it is criterion referenced. What does it mean? It means that there are certain levels that a student has to reach regardless of the group of students' level. In short, CBME does not focus on time. Its focus is to determine whether the student is competent. What has Thomas Fuller said once? A good archer is not known by his arrows, but by his aim. Let being competent to be your aim. You will achieve, no matter how. You can find further reading materials in the description below. See you and adios para amigos. And also, don't forget these flamingos.